Hello, dear student. All of you, welcome back in second lecture on chapter number 2, pteridophytes, from credit number 1st, from subject plant life and utilization paper 2nd. So I am Mukta Bhamre, assistant professor from botany department, KTHM College, Nasik. So the student, today's session agenda is the chapter number 2nd, pteridophyte, and in today's lecture we will focus on outline classification of pteridophytes according to the Sporne in 1976. In a previous lecture, we already seen that the pteridophyte introduction and general characters of pteridophytes. So the student, in today's lecture, outline classification of pteridophyte according to the Sporne in 1976. So the classification of pteridophyte proposed by K.R. Sporne in 1976, he was divided the pteridophyte into the 6 different groups or that classes. So the Psilopsida, it is a totally extinct class. Class number 2nd, Psilotopsida. Class number 3rd, there is a Lycopsida. Class number 4th, Spanopsida. Class number 5th, there is a Pteropsida. And class number 6th, there is a Progymnospermopsida. So the first, I am focusing here the Psilopsida. So the student, this Psilopsida class, it is having a totally extinct form. The plant body is a rootless sporophyte that differentiated into the substerian rhizome and aerial erect shoot. So the plant body, they do not having a root. Okay, instead of the root, there is a rhizome present, and at that rhizome they have a rhizoid. So the aerial shoot, okay, as well as the rhizome, they show the dichotomous type of branching. Then this rhizoids born on the rhizome, it's a functioning like as a root. They absorb water and nutrients from the soil. Leaves often absent, or if present, they are spirally arranged, and it is a scale like leaves are there. The vascular tissues is a primitive type. Okay, it is a simple cylinder or protostele, means central core of the organs, they have a vascular tissue, xylem and phloem, with annular or spiral tracheids are there. So the student, cambium is absent, that's why the secondary growth is absent. Sporangia, the spore producing organ, are born at the apex of the aerial shoots. They are either solitary, okay, example is Rhynia, or in the group and terminal in position. There was nothing like that of the sporophyll. Sporangia always bear the same types of spore. That means that sporangia are homosporous. Example, Rhynia and Astrozylon, both are the fossilized form. See the student, in this photograph, there is a Rhynia plant is there. See, this is the substerian rhizome is there. It is beneath the soil surface, okay, horizontally run. And see, there is where the lower side rhizoids are there. And upper side, they bear the aerial shoot. And each shoot, they show the dichotomous fork-like branching is there. And at the tip of that aerial shoot, they bear the sporangia. So the second class, there is a Psilotopsida. It is a living class. So it is a living Psilopsids present in this class. They also having a rootless sporophyte, but instead of the root, they have a rhizoids. The true leaves are absent. Instead of the true leaves, they present the scaly leaves. Vascular strands, they show the protostelic condition, protozylic condition is there. Cambium is absent. That's why there is no secondary growth. Sporangia born singly at the tip or in the group of axil of the scaly leaves. The sporangia, they produce the same type of spore, it is a homosporous. Example, there is a Psiloterm is there and Mesepteris. These are the two examples. See, this is a Psiloterm plant, okay. So this is the aerial shoots. They also show the dichotomous type of branching. And here the spore producing organ, it is nothing but the synangium is there. Okay, it is a produce the axil of the scaly leaves. So the student, see, this is another example. It is a Mesepteris, and this Mesepteris, it is attached to the other plant tree trunk or branches. Means it is a epiphytically grow on other plants. So the Class number three, it is a Lycopsida. The plant body, it is a sporophytic and it can be differentiated into root, stem and leaves. The leaves are very small. Okay, it is called the microphyllous type of leaves is there. The leaves are very simple with a single midvein is present. They are usually spirally arranged. Okay, sometime in an opposite fashion and or even it is in the form of whorl arrangement. In some cases, the leaves are ligulated. So the student, what is a ligule? Ligule, it is a nothing but the tongue-like outgrowth present at the base of the leaf. Okay, so this ligulated pteridophytes. Okay, the ligulated there is a selaginella and isolytes. It is a ligulated form. The ligule, it is a present at the base of each leaves. And what is the function of this ligule? Ligule keep the area of that leaves always hydrated. So the vascular tissues may be either in the form of plectostele or siphonostele. Okay, plectostele, it is in the form of that strip like, okay, or that strip or bands of xylem and phloem arrangement is there. Then siphonostele, they have a central core. They do not having a vascular tissue, they having a pith, or sometime even it is having a polystelic condition. So the student, lip gaps are absent. So the sporophylls are loosely arranged or aggregated to form the strobili or cones. Some members are homosporous. Example, there is a lycopodium is there, while other members are heterosporous. Okay, they produce the two different types of spore, microspore and megaspore. Okay, example is a selaginella. Heterosporous form have a endosporic gametophyte development is there, while in a homosporous form they shows the hexosporic type of gametophytic development. So after gametophyte, they produce the two different types of sex organ. Okay, male sex organ, it is a anthridia, while female sex organ is a archegonia. So anthridia, they produce the anthrozoids, and these anthrozoids are biflagellated or it is a multiflagellated, it having a many flagella. Secondary growth does not take place, but the student, you remember that the exceptional case is there, it is a isoites, they show the secondary growth. So the student, example of this class, lepidodendron, it is a totally fossilized form. Then second example is a lycopodium, selaginella is there, phylloglossum and isoites. These are the living member. See, this is the lepidodendron. It is a tree-like habit is there. Okay, it is a totally extinct on the earth surface and it's present remain today in the fossilized form. So the students, see, this is the lycopodium. Okay, see, this is the sporophyll. They compactly arranged and they form the strobili. See, this is a selaginella, heterosporous. They produce the sporophyll. Okay, that cone. That strobili, they bear the sporophyll, megasporophyll as well as the microsporophyll. Okay, see, this is a phylloglossum, they have a strobili. And see, this is the isoites, it is a, looks like as a garlic plant or onion plant. Okay, but it is a student, it is a pteridophytic plant and it's having a secondary growth. So the class number fourth, Spanopsida. The plant body is a sporophytic and can be differentiated into root, stem and leaves. The stem in majority of the form is a long, jointed or it is articulated and it is a ribbed stem having a ridges and grooves. The stem is divisible into nodes and internodes and is developed as upright aerial branches from the underground creeping rhizome. So the student, the leaves are very thin, small, membranous, scaly, brown in color and are arranged in a transverse whorl at the nodes of the aerial branches. So the student, these branches are also developed in the whorls from the axils of the scaly leaves. As the foliage leaves are reduced to scale, the process of the photosynthesis is takes place by the stem and hence it become evergreen. The stem has a solid protostelic condition is there. Okay, example, there is a spinophyllum or medullated protostele is there. In the example, equisetum is there. The sporangia are borne on a specialized appendages. That specialized appendages called the sporangiophore. The whole structure resembling but not homologous with the strobili. So the sporangia are developed at the apex of the fertile branches in the whorl forming the compact cone. Most of the members are homosporous, but the some fossil forms are heterosporous. Example, there is a Calamities. So the gametophyte, okay, after spore undergo germinate to produce the gametophyte, or it is a green photosynthetic prothalli, maybe monoecious. Okay, when the homospore germinate, they produce the monoecious prothalli. They produce the both the that sex organ, male sex organ, antheridia, while female sex organ is the achegonia. Or dioecious, when the megaspore germinate to produce the female gametophyte, okay, they only bears the achegonia, while the microspore undergo germinate to produce the male gametophyte, okay, they only consisting of the antheridium. So the gametophyte are hexasporic and green in color. Anthrozoites are large and it is a multiflagellated. They bears the many flagella. The embryo is without suspensor and it is a hexasporic in nature. So the student, important example, Equisetum, it is a living genera. Calamostichis and Calamities, these two are the fossilized form. See, this is the Equisetum. So the student, it is a living genera, okay, of the Spinosida. See, this is the looks like as a horse tail. Okay, so the student, this fern, it is a pteridophyte, it is a popularly known as the horse tail fern. Okay, and see, this is the another, there is a Calamities. It is a, see, the stem is a jointed, hollow, it's having a distinct node and internodes are there. And Calamities, it is a totally fossilized form. So the next class, there is a Pteropsida class. They occur in all types of habitats. Majority of the ferns are terrestrial and prefer to grow in a moist, shady and cool places. Some are aquatic, means they are specifically found in permanent aquatic bodies, water bodies, like as a lake, ponds. Example of aquatic fern, Azula, Salvinia, Marsilia. Some are xerophytic, example is Adiantum. Then some are the epiphyte, they grows on another plant, Asplenium is there. Then halophytic, example is Acrostichum, Avernum. Then climbing ferns are also there, there is a Steno, Calina. So the majority of the member, except some tree fern like as Angiopteris osmunda, have a short and stout rhizome is there, and the rhizome may be creeping underground, okay, or upright, or it is a growing above the soil surface. So the student, leaves are very large. It is a mega spilus, maybe simple, okay, in a orthoglossum, pinnately compound. Majority of the fern, for the example, like this is a Pteridium, Marsilia, Adiantum, the leaves are compound leaves, and that leaves are also described as a frond. Young frond during the younger condition, they are coiled. Okay, there is a succinately coiled condition is there. So the leaves are stipulate in order filicales. While stipulate leaves, it is also found in some other groups. The vascular cylinder, xylem and phloem, varies from the protostele to complicated type of siphonostele. Then it also shows the selenostele, dictyostele and proto polystelic condition are also found. So the student, in a this Pteropsida, okay, they shows the higher stellar diversity. Okay, then vegetative reproduction takes place by means of fragmentation. Example is Adiantum, Pteridium. Okay, then the stem tubers also produced. Okay, the example of the stem tuber producing plant, the example is see the example Marsilia. Then it's produced the adventitious root system. Okay, adventitious buds. Okay, example is Aspalium or Bulbiferum, or by apogamy, means without mixing of gamete, they also develop the sporophyte. Okay, example is Marsilia. Sporangia arises from the placenta. Placenta is a solen cushion of the cell. Okay, in a groups, it is called the sori. So the student, sori develop on the margins or in a abaxial surface of the leaves. Okay, so the sporophyll, or it is on the leaflet. Sori are protected by the true cavity-like structure. It is called the indusium. Example is a Marsilia, or false indusium cavity-like structure. It is Adiantum and Pteris. They have a false indusium. So the student, the sporangial development, it may be the leptosporangial type. It is developed from the single cell. Okay, example Osmunda. or the eusporangial type of sporangial development, it is from the group of cell. Example is ophioglossum. The sporangia in most cases have a distinct annulus and stromium. The vertical slit of the cell, it is called the annulus. The member may be homosporous. They bear the all same kind of spore. Example is a pteris and adiantum. Or heterosporous, they bear the two different types of spore, megaspore and microspore. Example is a Marsilia, Azula and Salvinia, etc. So the gametophyte may be hexosporic or it is endosporic. Okay, the Anthridia and Archegonia are partially or it is completely embedded in the gametophytic tissues. Anthrozoites, okay, the Anthridia produce the anthrozoites and these anthrozoites are multiflagellated structure. Embryogeny, largely endosporic. And after the zygote formation, the zygote undergoes the repetitive division forming the embryo. But that embryo, they may or may not have a suspensor. Example of the pteropsida member, okay. So, the example like as Azula, Salvinia is there, Marsilia, Nephrolepis, okay. You have in detail this Nephrolepis example in your syllabus, okay. Pteridium is there, Adiantum and Osmunda, etc. So, see, this is the Nephrolepis plant. See, the feather like leaves are there. See, the students, this is the Adiantum. It is called the walking fern. And see, this is the Osmunda. These are the some important examples. So, the student, last class is there, Progymnospermopsida. So, these plants having a vascular cambium with unlimited growth, potential present, as well as they have a well-developed xylem and phloem tissues are there. So these plants, okay, having the ancestors of earlier seed plant as well as the first true land plants, okay, true trees, then they show the strong monopodial growth exhibit through the axillary bud, and some heterosporous and some plants are homosporous. Example, Proteocalon is there and Archaeopteris, these are the examples. So, the student, in today's lecture, we already focused on the outline classification system of pteridophyte according to the Sporne in 1976. Okay, the Sporne divided the pteridophyte into the six different classes. Then, namely, the Psilopsida, then Psilotopsida, Lycopsida, Spanopsida, Pteropsida, and the last class there is a Progymnospermopsida. Okay, so we already seen in detail all the characters with suitable example. So the student, in next lecture we will focus on the life cycle of Nephrolepis. Okay, in next lecture we will cover the two different points, the systematic position of the Nephrolepis with a reason, and we will focus on external morphology of Nephrolepis. All these two points we will cover in our next lecture. Thank you.